During the sensitization tour, NSSF officials met workers with their employers at Lakeside Dairy Limited in Barra City. The company employs 300 workers with 80 registered with NSSF.
We do export to Kenya. And in Kenya, they do change once in a while. Today they say we don't need your products. The next day they say we need your products.
In March this year, the NSSF Acting Managing Director Patrick Ayota issued a 30-day amnesty for employers to register their staff.
When you're paying NSSF for an employee, that person is motivated because he knows in the future I will gain something, I will have retirement benefits. So it motivates them.
Karamaji says the deadline has been extended for another 2 months. He urged employers in Barra and other parts of Western Region to take advantage of the deadline period to register their employees, or they risk suffering heavy financial penalties.
To come forward and register with the fund so that the penalty they should have paid can be waived by the managing director of the fund.
Under the new NSSF law, Section 7 and 13 introduces mandatory contributions by all workers, regardless of the size of the enterprise or the number of employees.
But those who are charged with bringing in more employees for the daily work, those ones are the ones who have been eluding NSSF, but that was as per the old law. The new law now requires all of them.
Section 13 introduces voluntary contributions. Karamaji hailed companies that have already complied with the fund. Research shows majority of employees in Uganda have only NSSF as their savings for the future.
When Kenya blocks, that's when surely business goes down in actual sense, because like it or neglect it, Kenya is a big booster for the milk in Uganda.
Report compiled by Abdul Karim Sengendo for the news.